Hello everyone, in this video we will install and configure NetSNMP on Ubuntu. All used commands are available in description. We'll show my current Linux version. One of the way how to check is NetSNMP installed or not is to use systemctl. And it's not, as we can see. Just before installation, is recommended to update package list. NetSNMP consists of two parts, SNMP, that's SNMP utils, and SNMPD, that's the agent, which holds database and replies to queries. You can install only necessary part for you. Optionally, SNMP MIP downloader can be installed. It provides frequently used MIB files. All those files were MIB files. After installation was finished, we can check agent status. It's running and will be enabled after reboot. And now let's configure SNMP agent for version 2. It's better to backup configuration file. I will use Vim, you can use any your favorite text editor. Let's edit system location and system contacts. Later we will query those values. By default, agent listens only on Lubbock interface. We can add protocol and port where to listen. Then agent will listen on all interfaces. But let's configure specific interfaces to listen on. Views are specifying SNMP 3 access restrictions. We will create two additional views, all for full SNMP 3 access and MIB2 for MIB2 3 access only. RO community specifies read-only SNMP version 1 and version 2 community names. Those are used like an encrypted password with default value of public. RV community can be used for write access, but not included by default because of security measures. We'll create community string example with defined management server IP address and localhost IP address for tests. Also, we'll add view parameter. View and IP address are optional parameters. So, save and exit the file. Now, restart of agent service is required to apply changes. We'll verify the service is running according to configuration. And yes, it listens on configured interfaces. And now, let's configure firewall entry for manager access. And, of course, test our configuration. That was a lot of info. Definitely not default configuration. Let's verify location and contact, which were configured previously. Yes, those are the correct ones. SNMP version 3 user configuration. For user creation, it's convenient to use script, which is part of development package. Let's install this package. Before user configuration, agent service should be stopped. This command defines authentication passphrase and protocols, privacy passphrase and protocols, and of course new username. We'll create second user with the read-only access. Script creates entries in two files. At the end of this file you can see two commands. This file is recommended for user creation definitions. In this file, user access is defined. For this purpose, it's possible to use previously seen SNMP agent file. All of those file entries can be created manually. Now we can start agent and test configuration with defined parameters. Command defines previously configured authentication and privacy parameters. And read-only user. And now we'll proceed with NetSNMP tools configuration file. This command will show default MIB file search folders. First mentioned folder is user home directory, and others are MIB downloader used folders. Let's open global SNMP configuration file. This file defines that MIB files shouldn't be loaded. By commenting this line, all MIB files will be loaded from default locations. But that not always is a good idea and can create errors. We will create user-config instead. It should reside in .snmp folder in user home directory. Let's create folder and new configuration file. I will copy prepared configuration. First line here defines MIB files which should be loaded during query. And the following lines define default parameters for query. Save and exit config file. That's how query looked before the configuration. And after, we can use short format. Notice that import option was added. It can be used instead of custom configuration and will load all available MIB files. And we get MIB file error. That means some definition error is in place in that particular MIB file and file should be updated. That was the installation and configuration of NetSNMP. Thanks for watching. If you liked the content, hit like button and see you in the following videos.